Hi, I'm Dave Meaney, Vice President of Sales for ECS Incorporated. Today we'll discuss how quartz is manufactured. In our rapidly growing and fast-paced world we live in, it would be a challenge to find any high-tech electronics that doesn't utilize quartz for their system timing or basic clocks for their processors and microcontrollers. Quartz is so widely used. They're also used in high-end systems for timing, for networking and communications, base stations, GPS, cell phones, and many other electronics we use on a day-to-day basis. A quartz crystal has a complicated structure, but one that is the same for all crystals. So how do we cut these quartz crystals to maximize their potential? Each cut of the quartz has a major impact on its performance characteristics, but there are an infinite number of ways to cut on the X, Y, and Z axis. What we have learned is there are a few cuts that have best defined angles to offer the best performance under specific use. The four most prevalent cuts used today are the AT cut, BT cut, NSC cut, and the tuning fork. AT cut is the most widely used. It offers good performance over wide temperature range. These are mainly used in computers and modem applications. The BT cut is used to make high frequency crystal blanks because it's a higher frequency constant. These are mainly used in satellites and RF communications equipment. The SC cut will have an inflection temperature of about 92 degrees Celsius, and it'll operate in a temperature range of 80 to 100 degrees Celsius. That makes it perfect for OCXO designs. These are used in base stations and central office equipment. The tuning fork utilizes a tuning fork-shaped crystal blank to produce low frequencies in the kilohertz range, primarily used as timekeeping clocks and watches in computer systems. Once the crystal blanks have been cut from the ingot into their preferred cut, we can begin the process of making them frequency-specific resonators. At this point, they are slightly thicker than that required for the finished crystal, so they will actually resonate at a lower frequency than desired. We do this so we can slowly reduce the thickness of the crystal blank using a lapping process to bring the resonator up to the desired frequency. This lapping process is abrasive and damages the crystal surface lattice structure. So once we get close to the desired frequency, lapping needs to become more precise and a much finer lapping paste is used. Finally, the surface of the crystals are chemically etched. This provides a clean, smooth finish to the crystal lattice. The crystals are then washed and stored in nitrogen, pressurized cabinets to keep them from oxidizing. Today, quartz crystal resonators are available in many sizes, shapes, and formats. They are used in all sorts of applications, from oscillators and clocking circuits for microprocessing, timing elements in smartphones, sport watches, Bluetooth headphones, and most all electronics that surround you. For more information about ECS Inc. International and our electronic components, please visit our website at ecsxtal.com. My name is David Meaney. Thank you for watching.